Red V TV's instant fan reaction, supported by A-Star Recruitment for the 2019 season.
Up to 60 years, still not won it. 60 years, I said. 60 years, still not won it. Playing rugby the Warrington way.
Following Saints' 21-10 victory over the Warrington Wolves at the Halliwell Jones Stadium. We've acquired a Warrington fan, Adam, who wants to come on. Don't worry, Adam, we won't.
Well, we should just go now, yeah.
No, you can stay, don't worry. We acquire all fans at our club. I thought for a while in that game, Warrington might well grub us out of it for long periods. It's what they did last season in the semi-final. It worked. Steve Price came with similar tactics. Nearly worked again.
Yeah, probably. I just want to ask you just one question, and then I promise I'll be okay. Kind. Did the club keep the receipt for that play? it looked a long time. Like they went in 4-0 up at half time, two penalty goals and a bit of lacklustre Saints attacking. I think I put in the tweet just before half time, and it looked like Warrington were just gonna kind of, I don't know, win almost an arm wrestle. But I also tweeted that if we just kept in it and kind of put pressure on Warrington rather than pressure on ourselves, we'd win that game. I think that's the story of it, to be fair.
No, I was quite happy for Warrington to be taking them penalties, because despite Saints not probably getting into the gears that they needed to be in for long periods, Warrington kicking two each time kept us close. And you know Saints in the last 20 minutes of games are going to get some points on the board at some point. The penalty in the first half, the first one, Alex Walmsley, he gets an elbow to the face. He's distracted, doesn't get square. Failure gives the penalty the other way, with 2 points down. Lack of concentration, maybe, but it should have been a penalty Saints' way.
Yeah, agreed. Yeah. Even when, after the knockout, the penalty's been given, why isn't the referee looking at the screen?
I think once you've got a play on, you can't, but failure for me, so inconsistent. The play the ball tonight, Warrington lay on all night. Failure was given 1-4, but never seems to get a grip of the game. Aaron Smith goes off 2 minutes in. How much did that affect Saints' game plan? Did it put us off?
Yeah, I think a little bit it does, but I think James Bentley was magnificent tonight. I think he's not a
couple of the journalists said that upstairs.
Yeah, and I think he's had a great game. I think he stood in admirably. Yeah, he's come off towards the end when he started getting tired and we've put Morgan Knowles into the centre. I think that shows us up a little bit as well. But I think he's had a great game. It will put you off your stride because you won't be training with him as your first choice hooker all week. But he's got a chance, potentially, starting next week, whether Josh Eaves will come in or whether they'll stick with Morgan Knowles as him as the hookers. He's got a chance against Hull next week, and that'll be a big game. Thanks for the lighting, Warrington. Yeah. Looks like you've had a great idea.
Is there a slight concern that Saints get dragged down to... Yeah. The opposition's level, yeah. And we have won tonight by 11 points, but the way to probably keep games close against us is literally try and grub us out of it.
I think we either get dragged down to a level, whether it's into an arm wrestle rather than a bad level, because Warrington are one of the better teams in the comp. Obviously the league position doesn't lie there, or we just, like last week when we got dragged down to Leeds level, kind of just play what's in front of us instead of kind of probably sticking to what we want to. But that's it. I mean, while not robbing questions off you, Adam, is that how Warrington usually play? Would you show a team that much respect by taking three shots at penalty rather than running at it?
I've always been told to take the two. Yeah. Get the ball back, take the two, get the ball. We've done it countless of times at home where we've had a penalty literally in your 20 and we've lost it.
Yeah.
Example, I don't know, it was on telly, pulled down here. Our attack is so inconsistent.
Yeah.
And if you've seen the try we scored, it was off a short 10 when you...
We switched off for a second.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. I thought our defence was superb. First half was magnificent.
That said, I can understand why teams take the two and keep the scoreboard ticking over. But when you know a Saints side is likely to get 20-24 points on a board in a biggish game, I'm not going to say a big one because that's Wigan. Sorry. But it's three shots a goal where Warrington would have three shots at the Saints line. You only have to breach us on one of them three occasions minimum, to, or even force repeat sets to keep turning us over. And it felt for me, take them points, because we will at some point score some points in the game.
I just felt in our attack, if you keep Blake Austin and Dower Park quiet, like I said, for me in the first half we were fantastic, but you were comfortable in defence.
I think
there was not one point in the second half where we'll go through. Yeah. Like Johnny Lomax for me is your outstanding.
He's superb.
Yeah. Well, if we had a Johnny Lomax down here at least, we don't have any creativity. I mean, Patton has a stick over the weeks and we're just too slow in attack.
Yeah.
I mean, defence is fine.
I'm going to be awful out. Is Blake Austin overrated? Because we don't see him every week, but he seems to pick up the 3 points in the man of the match votes. Is he doing it against the big clubs, or is he running over teams who aren't playing well against you?
Running over teams who aren't playing well. I think tonight you see there was a bit in attack where he's dropping the ball to certain players and they're running through on the line, but I think our best player is Clark by a mile. If you keep Clark, our dummy half tonight was so quiet. I mean, in the second half we were trying to go and but.
Well, I said in the preview that we'd only struggle if Daryl Clark and Blake Austin kind of ran the show, and they didn't.
No.
So there's no threat there. I don't see
if
anybody
you control
else.
That,
I don't see a threat from fullback in Mamo. I don't see.
I thought Mamo was dodgy all night on that high ball.
The first one that went.
The first two of the two high bombs in the first half. He struggled against, and we didn't really test him the rest of the game apart from the last one for Lomax. When I was at stand over, I was calling for us to just kick long and kick into such and try and force an error. But he went down the middle, and Lomax followed his own kick up. Lads, 8 points clear at the top of the table now. Is essentially that done and dusted with 9 games left?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, I believe so.
Does it now? Obviously, we've got Hull away next week, Wigan the week after. Do you start rotating bodies again as you start looking towards the semi-final and Wembley potentially coming up?
With Wigan's form rising up again, that's a bit nice. But
they're winning games, aren't they?
You don't rest players in a derby. Whatever they're doing,
go full stretch. Maybe rest one or two next week, or
give the likes of Thompson. Maybe a rest.
Another rest.
Yeah.
Keep them fresh.
Imagine if we had James Robey controlling the rugby. Yeah.
Well, yeah, I said at half time, Bentley's been admirable, but we missed James Robey. James Robey in that team controls a lot more.
Start.
Yeah. And he probably would have got us a quicker to play the ball as well, potentially. But all in all, a decent night. Next week, Hull away. It is a tough one. It depends what Hull side turn up.
That's it. I've just been speaking to Adam about who they've got next, and they've got London away next.
Oh, right, Adam.
This story don't rest players like
no, we're 8 points clear. You're going to finish second. We'll meet at some point. Adam, this is your chance to speak to Steve Price and tell him to join the Relegate Leeds campaign. Are you on board?
Oh, I'd relegate Leeds any day of the week.
There we go. Listen, we've got a common goal. Steve, I know you're watching. I'm trying to get a jink in our arm. Well, you watch, so you're a fan.
Steve is.
I'm sure he is.
I hope he is.
Well, everybody from Warrington follows Saints, really.
How long have we got?
Closet Saints fans. Anyway, Steve, have a word with Justin. Justin, you're going to rest everybody in that week before that semi-final against Halifax against London, giving 2 points to London. Warrington will do the same and we'll be all square. It's fair enough to me.
To be honest, even before the ball was kicked, even if we won tonight, I think you're still rest everyone. You still finished top regardless. I think all hot and cold, aren't they?
That's it. Hull without Albert Kelly look a different proposition. They're asking Jake Connor to kind of fill in at six after he played at centre 1 week, full back the next week, and he's getting pushed about. Hull will still be a tough proposition. We don't always shine over them. And I said in the preview that it was a big 3 weeks for us. We've got past test one.
I hate to say it, but is anybody even the slightest concern that we're going to start to win games?
No.
But could Wigan grub us out in a playoff game should we meet them?
Wigan are like the Germans. You can never write them. You can never write off the Germans in like a World Cup or anything like that. And Wigan are like the Germans.
I feel like the only team to beat Wigan if they get in the playoffs is the Saints side. I think after what Warrington have done to them this year.
For me, I've got two concerns and we may face them both at some point. Warrington in the grand final.
Yeah.
because they can grub us out of it. Somewhere.
The due one.
They could grub us out of it, so we'd have to be on our guard. And if Hull defeat Warrington in the semi-final, we were to play them at Wembley. Hull on a big occasion, on a big stage, in a cup game, can turn it on against anyone. Doesn't matter who they are.
I worry about that at the end of August and the end of October, the beginning of October.
Who would you rather play at Wembley? Should we get there?
Oh,
Ducker. No, that's just.
Because you're not going?
No, not at all. Not at all. At 10 a.m. I'll be up for that game, trying to find a bar showing it. No,
or an illegal stream.
I don't care. Because when you're at Wembley, doesn't matter who you play, you go out there. We go out there and stamp our game on Hull or Warrington, we win the game. If we allow them to dictate how it's played, then we get a game where, like, the first 60 minutes of this, where they're still in it. I genuinely think we are. I'm not saying we're the best team ever to grace Super League, but currently we are the best team in the league.
Well, the best team to ever grace Super League was the Saints 2006 side, who lost four. We've currently lost two. That should be the ambition of this Saints side, to write themselves into history books.
Correct.
All right, just to end the show, lads, man of the match this evening for Saints. Well, not for Warrington. Sorry, mate.
I'll go with Max.
Go, Max.
You know what? I'll go a bit left field and give it Bentley then.
Okay, and go on, give us a Warrington one. But
Bentley was superb, especially when Hammersmith went off, which is a questionable decision. The Seater challenge in the first.
Well,
first
sorry,
5 minutes,
just before we go off. Now, Chris Chester has talked about his running technique, the way he runs the ball in with the shoulder. Now, it's currently legal, but it's borderline, isn't it? And talked about whether we'll see a rule change, and it looks innocuous. But do you think that one might be getting looked at?
You'd imagine so. If you can't shoulder charge in defence, as Jack Hughes found out, you shouldn't be able to shoulder charge and go in. It's not because it's against us. It's if it's unsafe. Bring it.
Just one more thing.
He's done it a couple of times actually.
OKR signed Matt Parcell. Would you, at this moment in time, with Robbie being rested and him getting on, would you have taken Matt Parcell to Saints? Would that not be the idea?
I think a Parcell at this stage of his career wants to play games, doesn't it? It's another masterful decision by Sir Kev. It just seems not a bad hooker to OKR. It's a bizarre one. It's like they've got. You wonder whether Leeds are going to bring somebody in because they've got two overseas players off. Yeah. They didn't need to get rid of him, did they? No. That said, hands up if you want to relegate Leeds. Right, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and we will catch you Wednesday for the preview. And big thanks to Adam for coming on, showing his face, showing his pride.
Showing his face.
And next week we'll see him in a Saints jersey. Catch you later, mate. See you later.